Keywords are a completely customizable, user-defined set of words which you can add to your documents to keep track of what's in a particular document or to make it even easier to search for something. For example, using keywords, you can track the themes or topics you discuss in various scenes, or perhaps characters that appear in each chapter, making it easy to find and compare these documents later. The Inspector has a dedicated section for keywords, which you'll find here under the Metadata tab. This tab tracks the keywords which have been assigned to this document. From here, you can open a floating keywords panel by clicking the cog icon and clicking Show Project Keywords. This can also be opened or closed by going to Project, Show Project Keywords, or using the keyboard shortcut Command-Shift-K. To create a new keyword, click the plus icon in the bottom left here. Since I'm using Wuthering Heights as my example text, we'll use this keyword to track Heathcliff. Now, by dragging this keyword into the keywords section of the inspector, or by clicking the cog again and mousing over Add Keyword, we can add Heathcliff as a keyword for this chapter. Note that this has only been assigned to this document. When I navigate to another chapter, the keyword isn't present here. If you want to go a level deeper and, for example, track the traits of your characters, you can set up additional keywords nested inside the first. I'll make sure Heathcliff is selected here, then I'll click the second plus button to create another keyword as a child of the first. We'll label this one Anger, and we can use it to track chapters where Heathcliff displays anger. We'll probably be using this one a lot. Note that anger hasn't automatically appeared in the keywords pane for this document. We can drag it in separately. One more useful tip. If you want to move a keyword along with its parent keyword, hold down the Option key as you drag them. I'll drag anger in here with the Option key held down, and you'll see that both Heathcliff and anger are now added to the keywords for this document. You can rearrange keywords in this panel in much the same way as you rearrange objects in the binder. You can click and drag a keyword to another position in the list if you want to reorganize. In this case, if I wanted to track anger as an overall theme of the book, rather than just one that applies to Heathcliff. This saves us the trouble of deleting a keyword, especially since deleting it would remove it from any documents we've already tagged. You might also decide that the colors Scrivener has automatically assigned to these keywords don't represent them very well. It's easier to track themes by colors you associate with those themes. Double-clicking on the keyword chip here, we can bring up a color wheel and assign Heathcliff a more bruised purple color and anger a dark red. I've now gone through and tagged the chapters in which Heathcliff is mentioned with our Heathcliff keyword. Returning to the keywords panel, I can highlight Heathcliff here and click the search button in the bottom right. The binder will now display any chapters I've tagged with this keyword. Keywords can also be a part of the display when you're viewing your project in the corkboard or the outliner. If we open the corkboard and enable View, Corkboard Options, Show Keyword Colors, you'll see these keyword chips appear on the right-hand side of each index card, allowing you to get a quick overview of which chapters have been tagged with that keyword. Likewise, if we go to the outliner and add the keywords column, you'll see the colored chips now appear alongside the other metadata for these chapters. That's all we're going to cover in this video. If you want to learn more about the features of Scrivener, our other videos should be linked nearby. Thanks for watching, and happy writing!